नमस्कार, विशिंग यू अ हैप्पी प्रॉस्परस एंड हेल्दी न्यू ईयर फ्रॉम अल्केमी ऑफ आयुर्वेद। 2020 वॉज अ वर्स्ट ईयर, वी हैड अ प्रॉब्लम इन हेल्थ, द COVID-19 वायरस डिस्ट्रॉयड आवर इकोनॉमिकल हेल्थ, आवर फिजिकल हेल्थ, आवर मेंटल हेल्थ। इन दिस कोविड पैंडेमिक everybody is eagerly awaiting the new COVID vaccine, but is vaccine only the answer for all the diseases? Yes, vaccines have prevented, eradicated crippling and life threatening diseases in the past, but can we prevent all the diseases with vaccine? All the infectious diseases can be prevented. What about the non-infectious diseases, the NCDs, non-communicable diseases? What are we going to do about all these diseases? Only vaccine? Vaccine will take care of everything? Now this vaccine for COVID-19, though it has been tested, but we do not know the long-term side effects of it. The efficacy of the vaccine itself is about 70% to 90%, not 100%. So it will not eradicate the disease like this. That is one thing. Secondly, over these 8 to 10 months, many of us have already got this infection, so they would have developed some immunity. Many of us would have got this infection, but they don't know they got it. It was a very mild infection, with or without symptoms, so they would have developed an antibody. Due to this, most of us would have developed a herd immunity. So whom are we vaccinating? Those who already have antibodies? Randomly giving to everyone? Is it okay? Is it right? Is it the way to vaccinate? Now the companies have manufactured the doses in millions. They will push down your throat and you will take it. It's okay. But my question is, yesterday you had SARS-1, the MERS, the Ebola, the swine flu. Today you have SARS-2, COVID-19. Tomorrow you will have some more. We invent vaccine for every disease. Nature always outsmarts us. It either mutates that virus or a new one erupts. How many more vaccines are you going to inject into your body? Is this the only way to take care of the disease? Then what is the solution? You would ask, what is the solution? What should I do? The answer lies in our old, age-old, time-tested Vedas, Puranas, Shastras. Yoga and Ayurveda has answer for these questions. You buy a Mercedes car worth millions of rupees, 2 crores maybe, and you just use it for next 5 years, don't service it, do nothing with that. Will it perform as efficiently as it should? The average, the engines, the engine knockings, it won't be effective? It will definitely. The best of the cars, the best of the vehicles, they require periodic servicing so that they are detoxified, so that they perform good, they sustain for long, they don't have any issues. You have body which is worth billions of rupees, you cannot put a price for it, and you don't want to service it anytime. Panchakarma is the servicing of your body, where you detoxify, where you rejuvenate the body, all your cells, your tissues, your body functions start performing in the best of their way, which helps in maintaining the health of the body. That is Panchakarma. Yoga and Ayurveda are the principal means to achieve which we can call as natural vaccine, to develop immunity against most of the diseases, to prevent most of the NCDs also. What you have to do? We need to regain or maintain health by way of proper diet according to our prakruti. Everybody has a different prakruti. All the foods will not suit each and every person. You need to know your body constitution, and according to that you have to take your diet. One. Secondly, you need to maintain your circadian rhythm, that is the dinacharya and ratricharya, the 24-hour daily regime. This will help in maintaining the circadian rhythm, which is the key to prevent most of the diseases, to keep your body healthy. You have to follow ritucharya. The seasons will change. There will be summer, there will be winter, there will be rainy season. So for every season, for every time, you cannot have the same food, you cannot follow the same regime. You need to make some changes. Ayurveda has told what changes to be made. You should know that. You have to do periodic detoxification of your body, the panchakarmas. There will be variations in the body, doshas. There will be changes in the body, there will be toxins in the body because of your daily routines, your work, your diet. You need to detoxify your body to get rid of those toxins. Then you need to do rasayana karma, that is rejuvenation. By doing all these things, you will maintain your body. There won't be any toxins in your body. There won't be any variations of doshas, the main body elements. Your tissues will be healthy. This will help in maintaining the health. This will help in maintaining your immunity. The second factor is the psycho, neuro, endocrino, immunology. One should understand that just by keeping the body healthy, you cannot stay away from the diseases. Because the epigenetics have proved, the new science, epigenetics, the researchers have proved that mind plays the most important role in maintaining your body, maintaining your immunity, prevention of diseases. 90% of the disease are due to mental stress. Only 1% are due to genes, genetics. So your state of the mind determines how healthy are you going to stay. The more control we are going to have on our mind, the more power we are going to have in our life. How to achieve this? Yoga. Yoga, not only asanas. Yoga is not only asanas. Asanas is a part of yoga. You need to have breathing techniques, that is pranayama, the breath control. You need to have equanimity in the event of emotions. Maintain equanimity in the event of emotions. Cultivation of mind-body awareness through meditation. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. These are the Ashtang Yogas. You start from Yam and Niyam, that is do's and don'ts. Asanas, maintain your postures. Pranayama, the breathing technique. Pratyahara, restraints. Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, the further states of meditation. By doing all this, you control your mind, you slow down your mind. Health is not merely an absence of disease. A calm and a contented mind in a healthy body can be termed as a state of natural vaccine, a state of positive health. This is what we should achieve.